thank you so much for clicking on this video. If this is your first time here, kindly please click the subscribe button, turn on your post notification, and every time there's a new video, you'll be the first one to be notified. So I'm back with part two of the video that I posted on things you should know before coming to Namibia. You know, the cost of living in terms of schooling, in terms of healthcare, in terms of childcare. So in this video, I'm going to be focusing on transport and, you know, household utilities, you know, mobile network, internet, television, and so on. So let's quickly dive into the video. But before we do that, kindly please share this video on your communities, on your social media pages. There might be somebody that might find it very helpful. So let's get into the video. So before I go on into transport and others, so there was a question actually on the previous video where somebody asked about renting a house in Namibia. Do you pay monthly? Do you pay yearly? And so on. All right, now renting a house in Namibia means that you'll be paying monthly. But before you move into that house, you need to be paying a deposit that is equivalent to the amount that you'll be paying for rent. For example, if the house is going to be 7,500 Namibian dollar per month, it means that when you move into that house, you have to pay 7,500 deposit plus 7,500 for that month, that specific month that you'll be moving into the house. So that means that you'll be paying about 15,000. I hope my math is right. So that means that you'll be paying 15,000 for that first month that you'll be moving in. The deposit is actually refundable when you move out of that house. So at the end of the contract, if you feel like you want to move out, you've gotten something better, what's going to happen is that your landlord or landlady will come into the house, check if there's something broken. So if there's something broken, then that thing has to be replaced. So they are going to deduct from the amount, the deposit amount that you have paid at the beginning of the month that you moved into that house. All right. So that is on deposit. Now, whether you pay monthly or yearly, that can also depend on you. You can pay in advance, actually. So there are people who would say, okay, I'm going to pay for this house, like, you know, let's say for 6 months, all right? Or I'm going to pay for it for the whole year, exactly when I move in, at the time that I move in. However, if you feel like you want to be paying monthly, you can also be paying monthly. But most people actually pay monthly. But for those that have enough money and they feel like, let me just, you know, settle this for the whole year, then I don't have to be paying the month. That is up to you, actually. So you can talk to the landlord and then you do that. I think that is the question that was asked, and I hope that I have addressed that. So remember, it's the deposit that you have to pay, which is refundable, and then of course the rent amount for that month that you are moving in. However, you can pay more if you want to pay more, or if you want to pay certain months in advance. Now, another thing you should know is that the deposit, if you feel like you do not have the full amount, you know, for the deposit in the month that you are moving into the house, you can actually negotiate with the landlord or the landlady, actually, so that you can pay it in 2 months. I don't know if there are people that have paid it in 3 months, but it's up to the landlord or the landlady to agree. So you can pay it in 2 months. So let's say your deposit is 7,500. You pay 7,500 for your rent, and then the 7,500 for your deposit can be divided into two. So that means that you're going to be paying about 3,000. I think it's 3,750, if I'm not mistaken, if my math is very good, for 2 months. Once you've settled your deposit, then you can be paying the amount for the rent every month. So that is how it works with housing. Okay, so the transport system that's commonly used in Namibia is basically taxis for people that do not have you know, cars, you know, to move around, to go to work, to go to school, and so on. It's taxis. Now, our taxis here in Namibia are not as the taxis in the European countries, where you have to, you know, book them, and the taxis are basically expensive and so on compared to normal buses, because in European countries they have buses. In Namibia, we have, I've seen a few, especially in Windhoek, the municipality buses, that actually take people at a very lower rate compared to the taxes. But our taxes are also very cheap. Like recently, I think they've increased the taxi fare. Before, people were paying $12, and now people are paying $14 or 14 Namibian dollars. This is Namibian dollars. I'll try and put it in US dollars. So that is what you pay to actually get taxes that can take you around. Unlike taxes that you have to book and you'll be the only one in the taxi, taxes here, you just have to stop them at the taxi ranks or along the road as they pass by, and then they'll be taking you to your destination. When you want to travel between towns, we have also other taxis that we call buses, rather. Okay, we have the public ones, and then of course we have those ones that are kind of like private. So those are buses that travel long distances, and usually in the past they used to travel at night, but due to COVID they changed their schedules. So those buses, last time I checked, like we have this, I think it's called the Oasis bus. The Oasis bus is 350 per person. I think if you have to travel, let's say from Windhoek to the northern regions, it goes up to Zambia, Livingstone, and I think it also goes to Zimbabwe. I'm not quite sure about that. Back in the days, we used to have the Intercape that would go to South Africa, up to South Africa. And then, of course, we have another bus. I can't remember the name, guys. If I'm going to remember it, I'm going to put it up there, that also transports people to the northern regions. That is if you want to travel between towns. And then you'll get private cars as well, owned by certain people that would transport people to different towns. And then there are seven seaters that take people to different towns, to the coast and so on. So that is if you want to travel out of the town that you stay to a different town. And of course there are also those buses like Ivecos and all that that can transport people. And the fee actually depends on the town that you are going, but mostly it ranges, I think, from $100, especially if you're coming from Windhoek going to Okahandja, or it might be less than that. And then of course up to 350 if you're going to the north, or maybe even 400 now, because it keeps changing. All right. So now within town, if you want to buy your own car, because it's more convenient to basically have your own car, you know, to get around places and so on. So if you feel like, oh, I've got, you know, money to purchase a car that I'm going to use temporarily, or that's going to help me to actually go to places in town, cars here, the price actually ranges from the condition of the car, whether it's a second hand, whether it's a first hand. We have the giant Japanese cars such as the Hondas and so on. These cars actually would range, the price would range from as little as 30,000 Namibian dollars, depending on whether you are buying a used car, whether you are buying, you know, a brand new car. So for used cars or cars that have been with the owners before and so on, so it might range from 30,000 Namibian dollars, depending on the type of car model as well. You know, these Nissans, Honda Fits and so on, they are actually very cheap. Even at giant Japanese cars, you'd find them at 50,000 Namibian dollars and so on. And then of course we have these Volkswagens. The most common cars in Namibia that I've seen are Volkswagens, because they are very much convenient to use. It's easy to find parts. Basically, people buy cars depending on how it's going to be for you to service the cars. Is it going to be easy for you to find the car parts and so on? But you'd find Hondas, you find Hyundais. Is it called Hyundais? You'd find Toyotas. Toyotas are also very, very much common in Namibia. And then a lot of them, Renault Sanderos and so on. So again, if you feel like you want to get your own car in order for you to get to places very fast, because taxes might be delaying you, especially if you're very late, if you're coming here as a family, and of course you need to get to places with the whole family, it would be very much convenient to actually get a simple car that can take you to places. If you feel like, no, you are very classic, you can afford, you know, expensive cars that are ranging from 100,000 and above and so on, then you can also go ahead and purchase your own car that you're going to use as a family. Because taxes now, especially if you have to get to different places on the same day, it means that you'll be paying $14 to a certain place, another $14 to another place, and so on. Also, you should know that there are places that do not have taxi ranks, or that are far from other places. So if a taxi is picking you at a place that is not having a taxi rank, you have to pay double. If a taxi is dropping you at your house, going inside the neighborhood and so on, you have to pay $14 if there is no, I mean double for that if there is no taxi rank. So in smaller towns, the taxi fare would also be the same. The taxi fare actually doesn't range from town to town. But the advantage of staying in a smaller town is that then you might not have to pay taxi, because then you might be staying in a place that's nearby town, so you might be walking to town and so on. So it really actually depends on where you are staying, how you're gonna spend your money, whether you're gonna save. It also depends on where you are staying. But so moving on, let us talk about television. So in Namibia, we have two types of televisions or TV broadcasts that are basically Namibian, that is One Africa Television, and then the national television, which is NBC. And so we also have DSTV that, you know, have different channels. It depends on the bouquet that you are paying for. So the channels that you're going to watch on DSTV would basically depend on the bouquet that you are paying for. Also know that you need to have a TV license. You know, there are certain years, I haven't had it in a while now, where, you know, the NBC people would go from house to house. If you own a TV set, you need to have a TV license that you'll be paying for. The bouquet that you're going to pay for DSTV, which has different channels, American channels, you know, African channels, and then there's GoTV also, and so on. The DSTV would charge, I think, from as little as 200, if I'm not mistaken, depending on the bouquet that you're paying for. So the more you're gonna pay, the more you're gonna get more channels that you're gonna watch. And then, of course, GoTV is basically the cheapest, but I believe that GoTV doesn't have all the channels that you'd find on DSTV Namibia. DSTV Namibia is just like DSTV everywhere in Africa, DSTV Nigeria. It all depends on the bouquet that you are paying for. If you have to pay for the full bouquet where you're going to have all the channels, and that means that, you know, you'll be paying more money. I think it's 1,000 something. It's easily available on the internet, where you can check which channels are available and how much you're going to spend on such channels. And then, of course, another thing also you should know is that the mobile network that we use here, there are two mobile networks, which is the TN Mobile and the MTC. Now, the TN Mobile is basically, I feel like people feel like it's better if you need more internet, because they have a lot of specials. It's the TN Mobile that you can get. You can also call and so on. They give you seconds to call. And then the MTC, it also does have different specials where you can actually purchase a certain option where you are given data, both social media data to use and so on. These two mobile networks actually also have packages for internet. You know, you can find all these on the internet, or you can rather just call them and then find out what are the packages. If you need me to speak specifically on that, just let me know. Banking system, we have about I think five banks, if I'm not mistaken. We have the Standard Bank, we have the Nedbank, the Binuk, FNB, Banco BIC, which is BIC. And what other banks do we have? So those are the banks that we have. When you have to open a bank account or maybe a saving account, I believe you'd have to take your passport. There are other requirements, so you just go there and you ask them. I'm not gonna go deep into that because I haven't researched on it, but if you want me to do that, I will do that. So you just go to the bank, you ask what are the requirements that you need in order to open your bank account, because I believe it's easier to actually open a bank account and put your money into your account than having money at home. However, if you have a card, you know, there are cards, I think, that are called MasterCards that you can also use in Namibia. So yeah, I think that's it for now, and I'll see you again in my next video. I love you so much. Thank you so much.